This silicon wafer is the base of all the electronics in your life. Yes, you heard me right. You should thank this wafer for making your cell phone, iPad, and your television work. The circuits that control the electronics are built on top of the wafer and are highly structured and complex. Then, the wafer is cut into thousands of smaller pieces. Well, as technology has improved, the size of those pieces has become smaller, and how we create the circuits has become smaller. Nanoscale, in fact. Letting us pack more of them onto a chip and making those electronics smarter. Nanoelectronics is how we use nanotechnology to build electronics with nanoscale features. And it's a field of study where researchers are still creating new methods to build. Innovation Workshop student reporter Ariana has more.
I'm about to get a sneak peek into the NanoFab. The Fab in NanoFab stands for fabrication, even though I'd say it's fabulous. Let's check it out. So first question, why are we in these suits?
Well, we're in these suits because we're going to enter a clean room. And the clean room is a room basically without dust. We have to cover our skin and our clothes in order to prevent any dust from escaping from us and contaminating the wafers and all the circuits that we're going to make in this room. Time to go inside the clean room. Let's go.
Inside the NanoFab, the focus is on creating and building nanotechnology. See, nanofabrication uses a variety of methods to make nanoscale electronic circuits or devices, like the data chips in your cell phone or your iPad. Starting with a silicon wafer as a base, materials can be deposited on top or etched off, and patterns can be created through various processes.
So this is a typical starting substrate called a wafer. It happens to be 100 millimeter, it can go up to 200, 300 millimeters. We want to define a pattern on it, and the pattern will be chips, and the chips later on will be cut up and go into a computer, for example, on circuit boards.
Photolithography adds a pattern of electrical circuits on top of a wafer using a mask. It's kind of similar to the way we used to develop film to make pictures from cameras.
What I'm holding here is called a photomask. This is what I put on top of the wafer. So this is a piece of glass with a layer of chrome with holes in the chrome, as you can see. And my wafer will go underneath and the ultraviolet light will come from the top. And that's why we expose the wafer through the holes in the mask. Now the wafer itself now has the pattern transferred onto it.
And that's just the first step of many to create the data chips in your cell phone. Other techniques can also be used to imprint a pattern.
We are here in front of the nano imprinter, which is basically a stamping tool, which is going to transfer a pattern from a mold onto the whole wafer at the nanoscale, creating series of lines, series of interconnected lines, series of pillars, series of holes. Any arbitrary pattern you need to define your circuit can be made on the mold and transferred onto the wafer hundreds of times, down to about 10 nanometer in size. It's very cost effective because the whole wafer is imprinted at one time.
Depositing materials on top of the silicon wafer allows researchers the potential to build something with improved electrical properties. After all, who wouldn't want a faster, smaller, or more efficient cell phone? This large and very loud machine has an accuracy of 1 nanometer, and there's less than 100 of these in the entire world. Look at how complicated this machine is. What is it?
To make nanotechnology circuitry, which are very small, you need very big machines. This is an ion beam deposition system, which is capable of depositing very thin layers of metals or insulators on the wafer. Right now we have things like gold, platinum, titanium. We have also oxides, which are very useful. Some are used as insulators, some are used as conductors.
The NanoFab is unique because it's open to students, researchers, and even businesses. Nanotechnology is a growing field that requires more and more skilled people to design, create, and build. So the NanoFab provides access to and even training on the complex and sometimes very expensive equipment.
Wow, look at that.
So what is your favorite part about your job?
My favorite part about my job is really helping people who come and use our facility. And we try to bring them up to speed as fast as possible so they can get results. The second part is to improve on existing processes or develop new processes, novel processes, which are going to allow better performance on devices, new devices for industry.
The main thing about nanotechnology is the ability to create and build at the nanoscale, 1/1,000,000,000 of a meter in size. Clearly, the tools inside the NanoFab are unique and offer opportunities to create nanotechnology. Innovation involves creating and building something new. Even if you have the design for something, you still need the tools to build it. Just like a carpenter uses hammers and nails, nanofabrication requires special equipment to build.
Nanotechnology is how we're manipulating materials to create better materials, to build better things, but all on the extreme nanoscale, 1/1,000,000,000 of a meter in size, itty bitty, teeny tiny. Perhaps you'll be the one to create something new using nanotechnology, or the one to create a more advanced microscope to explore nanoscale materials. Nanotechnology is more than just one innovation. It's a movement that's revolutionizing the materials we build with and showcases how humans push for new ways of thinking and doing. From all of us at Innovation Workshop, thanks for watching.